Good morning, Madam Senator.
Good morning, Sito. How's it going? I'm here in Ilocos. I fled the NCR PLUS or NCR PLUS Bubble GCQ. NCR Super Pro Max. Ewan ko ba?
I am... Well, it seems we all belong to the group who fled. Anyway, in any case,
devout cowards from COVID.
Madam Senator, just to start, get the ball rolling, I really don't know where to start. Should I start with COVID-19, with the vaccines or with the IATF? First, I recall early last week, you made the statement na parang, ano ba itong IATF na ito, dapat ito, you can please correct me if I'm wrong, parang you were suggesting dapat i-overhaul, revamp, or palitan na.
That's right. That's absolutely correct. Tagal ko na sinasabi, overhaul na natin, the IATF, because clearly the issue at hand is a health issue. And if it's a health issue, huwag na tayong nagmamarunong at nagdudunong-dunong at palibasa na Google, WebMD na tayo. Hindi naman pwedeng ganun. So I said, let's have a science-led, medicine-driven campaign and establish policy with a core group of doctors, health and public health experts, immunologists, so that we get a grip on this because we've been at this for a year. Everyone's nakapreso sa bahay ng isang taon. Yung mga anak natin walang natututunan kundi yung sinasabi lang natin na laro. Yung mga tatay at nanay na wala na ng trabaho, wala nang kinikita. Mabigat to in economic affairs. You know, the committee's been really mothballed more or less because of all the complaints. Hindi na kami nagmi-meeting. Wala na mapag-usapan kundi joblessness. So I was recommending that we should have such a core group, bring on the local government officials kasi sa kanila pala i-delegate lahat ng implementation eh. Bring them on board as part of the IATF. And also bring in the private corporations because at the end of the day, they are the ones going to pay pala. We don't have money pala to import all these vaccines. So let's bring in all these relevant people and then let's have everyone volunteer because our health workers are at their wits' end. Why don't we have the health workers also talking? What do they need? What support? In the beginning, we had no PPEs. Now we simply have no hospitals. So this is what we need to start working on. And if it's square one be it after this horrible year.
Okay, well, that's a good point. If it's necessary to go back to square one, at least let's go back to square one starting right. Now, in fairness to the IATF, in fairness to certain government officials, they have reacted to your statement saying that meron naman kami sitong maraming tinatanong ng mga doktor, hindi lang puro general, at marami rin kaming na-achieve, marami rin nagawa. What's your reaction to that?
Well, I think that's true. That's true. As you know, I'm a solid admin. I'm a solid administration senator. Hindi naman ako opposition. I'm not running for any office until 2025. I think I still have a job. So there's no politicking involved. Ang akin na lang is friendly criticism. Let's get on with this because people are suffering in a major way. But the rank incompetence of the decision so far, like you read kanina, yung headlines natin tungkol sa simbahan. Sabi ng DOH, there's no such ruling na bawal yung magsimba. On the other hand, sabi, nagkasundo na daw. Tapos sabi naman ng mga bishop, sana kinonsulta man lang kami dun sa 10% namin o maglalagay kami ng loudspeaker. Ano ba talaga? So parang ang gulo eh, because right now, as we know, the IATF is really representing every single department, di ba? So parang mini cabinet lang siya. Eh para sa akin, hiwalay yun na yun kasi may trabaho sila eh. They're running departments are running gigantic bureaucracies, it's really important that we have a dedicated crew that's once again based on doctors, on science, and then implemented by local government officials who know what's going on the ground, and then involving also the private sector and the health workers, because the health workers are at their wits' end. They're calling for medics, they're calling from military and police trained volunteers. We have OFWs from the health sector overseas who are now stuck at home. Why don't we bring them on board? Lahat na yan. Pwede natin magtulong-tulungan at i-body system sa LGUs natin.
Okay, Senator, I was quite surprised when I read many senators had supported this proposal, the revamp or replacement of the IATF composition. And how did that happen? Meron bang nag-push, may nag-lobby ba sa Senado, or is this a consensus, a common sentiment of the senators na they're fed up with the way things are being run?
Yes, I think so. I think that's what occurred. In fairness to the senators, we've been conducting vaccination hearings. Wala na kaming ginawa, di ba? Kasi sunod-sunod yan eh. Since September, we've been hearing yung Bayanihan. Yung Bayanihan 1 came out in August. Pagkatapos nun, Bayanihan 2. Pagkatapos nun, may vaccination law that came out in February of 26. Then we have the budget, which was ongoing all through September to December. So wala na kaming ginawa kundi magka-vaccination hearing. Parang 24/7 na yan for how many months. And alam naman ninyo, we called for the resignation of Secretary Duque. I felt really bad about it because he comes from Region 1 in Northern Luzon. But at the end of the day, you do what you have to do. But I think the last straw was the latest administrative order. They claimed it was a draft, but draft or no draft, it cut out great sway of the economy from importing vaccines. Nagmamagandang loob na, i-donate na 50% to the government, 50% for their employees, but they banned like huge industries, sugar, anything with sugar, with soft drinks, anything with alcohol, anything with breast supplement products, all the milk industries, and then of course tobacco. Eh, ilan yan? Ilan kinakain? Cut out niyan, million-million niyan. That's San Miguel, Nestle, Magnolia. How many people are you cutting out? Alaska, you're taking out all the Andrew Tan companies. You're taking out all the Lucia Tan companies. Eh, yan yung mga nag-donate. Kasi saan tayo makukuha niyan kung ibabawal yan? Then, of course, the prohibitions on the different federations from the Chinese-Filipino community started coming out. Apat na yon, the Federation of Filipino-Chinese Chambers, the Filipino Federation of Industry and Commerce. And so they were all getting rejected because it was said that perhaps kikita daw sila. Baka ibenta raw ng mga Chinoy at pagkakitaan. Eh, hindi naman yun ang solusyon eh. Hayaan mo mag-import yan, tutukan mo ng mga safeguards. So I think everyone just said, hey, tigilan na itong kalokohan na to.
Okay, well, pursuing what you just said, it occurred to me yesterday as I came home that the senators should call an investigation. Ewan ko kung may embank kayo, no? The Senate as a whole to investigate all the activity of the DOH and the IATF. Go through them one by one. Kahit abutin na kayo ng tatlong buwan para magkaalaman so that we can find out what action, how were this done. Kasi ang question po, Madam Senator, is saan nang gagaling itong mga ideas? Like this draft resolution that you mentioned, some people are saying it's mythical. I know that there is a group inside DOH that is actively against all of the companies you mentioned. Their purpose, on the surface, is correct. They are against tobacco, alcohol. They want to promote breastfeeding. Pero sabi ko, I may be an advocate, but that's crossing the line. You don't ban these people from bringing good to their employees. Are you going to call for a thorough investigation of these individuals or find out who's responsible for this draft?
Yes, well, I have to say, I'm not a media practitioner, but like you, I can't divulge sources. Let me simply say it's semi-official, because many people in the cabinet, as well as their staff, as well as their researchers, objected violently to the suggestion that all these industries, hindi kumpanya to, ah, hindi negosyante, industriya na banned. Eh, dapat hindi naman ganon. So they provided us a copy. Ang point ko, draft or no draft, it looked like a fairly conclusive and well-written document and ready for the signature of the president. And that's a real concern. There have been accusations on one hand that the FDA takes too long, as well as the DOH, because they're in the clutches of big pharma. The big pharmaceutical companies don't want them to approve Sinovac or any of the Chinese products. They don't want them to approve Sputnik 5 because it's Russian and outside of this big pharma cartel. So may nagsasabi nun. On the other hand, may nagtuturo naman na nagsasabi, eto, yung do-gooding health advocates daw are in the clutches naman daw of Bloomberg, the Union, and so on, who are spending millions here in the Philippines to send them to school, give fat research grants, travel, at ang sabi, binaband rin daw yung mga produkto na they term the sin products. Eh, masaklap yun eh. It's a sugar lang. How many are you talking about? There are 3.4 million sugar farmers, workers, millers. There are 2.2 involved in tobacco all the way up to the export, which is 70% export in many cases. And then so on and so forth. So we are really horrified by this. And these allegations, nakaka-paranoid na nga eh, but somebody did say that paranoids also have enemies. So I don't know. Is it big pharma or is it the health advocates?
Okay, Senator Imee, you mentioned earlier you are a pro, you are an administration senator. You are staunchly pro Duterte. There are people who have this strong feeling that the president is no longer accessible to other inputs, other information outside of this core group of cabinet members. That seems to be validated by the fact that you had to go to the media to expose all of this incompetency, these failures in the IATF and in the vaccine program. Do you no longer have access to the president?
Well, it's becoming harder and harder to see him. Obviously, there's a concern because of COVID-19. He's clearly a senior citizen like the rest of us. Mm-hmm. And he clearly prefers to live in Davao, and the travel restrictions have been onerous. So his birthday is coming up. Let's see what happens. But I've had to send word, and we've all tried to send word. We've sent all sorts of letters, for example, with Senator Villar about the agricultural shortages, because we're so deeply concerned about these threats to our food supply in the middle of all these pandemic havoc. We also have shortages in food, inflation, and so on. So we tried our very best to send it to him privately. And sometimes you get a response and there's action taken. But like you said earlier, the ability to consult and to brainstorm becomes less and less. The pandemic, I'm certain, has a lot to do with it.
Okay, now what's the plan of the Senate, or you as a senator, what are your plans to improve the situation? Because, you know, you making a suggestion through the media that we overhaul the IATF is one thing. Whether or not that happens is another thing, because people are angry. I have to be honest about it. Everywhere I go, people are mad already. I mean, just last night, I was in my Bible study group and someone stated, you know, if they keep using fear as a way of for leadership, there will come a time when we stop being afraid and we are going to get angry. And I was like taken aback. It's like, whoa, iba na to. Pastor na itong nagsasabi na ito. And this concerns me. at every level, Filipinos are fighting with each other, arguing about policies, about application of policies. Pero sila, relax lang sila sa opisina nila.
Eh, nakaka-nervous ngayon eh. I think the pastor that you talk about is not the only one who's angry and frustrated. To a great extent, you and I are very, very lucky. We're very comfortable in Libay. I'm very comfortable in Lawag. We have food. We have a nice place to stay. But so many are unemployed. I mean, it's been grossly unfair. And the marginal sectors are really hard put. Inis na inis ako pag sinasabing pasaway eh. Furious when they say all these people are pasaway kasi hindi sumusunod sa health protocols. Paano ka naman susunod sa health protocols sa depressed area? Sabihin mo sa akin, saan doon yung 6 feet na physical distancing? Eh, isang dosena kayo nagsisiksikan sa isang kwarto. Maawa naman kayo. May poverty na nga of means. May poverty pa of space. I really don't understand. And then there's outrageous things like wag na mag-physical physical distancing, higit sa lahat, ang bawal, no PDA, no holding hands. Eh talaga naman, mag-asawa yan eh. They're living in the same house. Ano bang gusto niyong mangyari? And then that funny thing about the barrier, do you recall? So many things are exasperating and ludicrous. Now, I have to say that it's been really, really tough for so many of my friends, and too many people are dying and getting sick. This is hitting too close to home. Masakit na eh. Masakit na talaga eh. So, my mother's 92 years old, and she's diabetic. We're so scared. And then my brother got hit very early on in May. Bongbong nagkasakit, isa sa pinakauna. At naswertehan lang, the hospital was so full, hindi siya na ventilator, which at that point in time was the state of the art treatment. Eh yung pala, tamang-tama, oxygen lang siya kasi got stuck at home. So these are things that are so awful. Last week, yung apo ko, eh sabi, he said, Lola, how come like this? I was 3 years old, then the virus came, so I didn't have my dancing party when I was 4 years old. Now I'm 5 years old, I still don't have my dance party. I mean, you know, this seems silly and trivial, but at the end of the day, the children, kawawa naman sila, they're really having a rough time. They need the socialization with their peers. They need to go to school. They need to play and be happy in the sun.
Yeah, well, I'll add to that, Madam Senator, just so that a lot of our friends who are senior citizens, particularly those who are 65 years old and above, I'm sure they're also angry. Kasi kahapon, we went to SNR, me and my wife, who is 60 years old, and when we reached the entrance, we were stopped and we were carded. Hiningan kami ng ID to show our age. Parang sabi ko, anak ng ewa naman, ang kinakard yung pumapasok sa disco at sa bar na minor de edad. Hindi kami...
Oh, when you were 17 and trying to make push-lip.
Exactly. And you know, but it brought home a reality. What about our senior citizens, 65 and above, who cannot, who don't have help, who don't have people in their homes, and who insist on in their independence. At tapos sasabihin, bawal po. And then nung tinanong ko, paano nga kung ako lang yung dumating dito at wala akong ibang kasama? Papapasukin naman po namin kayo. Sabi ko, anak ng pating naman ng mundo ito. Ano ba nangyayari sa Pilipinas?
Tulog talaga. Naaawa rin ako sa mga enforcers kasi hindi na nila alam kung anong ginagawa nila. And then, yun nga, yung mga hinihinto ng pulis, yung hindi matatag yung kaisipan, di ba? We had these incidents where medyo may kakulangan, di ba? Yung isang nasa border, tapos hininto, inaresto pa. I think this is getting ludicrous. I'm not against these lockdowns, okay? They should be very, very specific to my mind, perhaps per street, per sitio, per barangay, pwede yan. It should be time-bound and very, very strictly enforced. But they're of no use. We've had 1 year of this. only useful if it's accompanied by mass testing, by serious contact tracing, and now with vaccination, really aggressive vaccination for anyone who's willing to be vaccinated. Dapat may kasabay yun eh. Kung lockdown ng lockdown, card ng card, tapos aresto ng aresto, wala rin mangyayari yun eh.
Eh, pero ang lumalabas, Senator, and you know me, I'm a neutral person, hindi naman ako nakakalait na lahat naman kaya kong maging kasundo. Pero lumalabas, nauna yung salita kaysa sa gawa, nauna yung bibig kaysa sa daliri. What happens is, noong December, marami sa amin nagtampo kasi sabi ni Presidente, unahin ko yung mahihirap, darating na yung mga bakuna, lahat yung 70% ng pulubi sila ang una. And then ngayon lumalabas, wala palang bakuna, puro donation lang ang dumadating. At least, I mean, to the president's credit, he was being transparent and honest. But what do we do now? Our vaccines are not coming until May or June.
Well, I don't know. The president said that he's hopeful they'll be coming in March. I really don't know. Hilong-hilo na kami. We approved 10 billion already with the DOH. I don't know where those vaccines are. We borrowed from the ADB, the World Bank, a total of 116 billion plus, plus, plus. And yet all we have are donations. What's taking so long? We've heard the frustration of those who negotiate on our behalf. Ambassador Romualdez, si Babe. Pagkatapos si Secretary Teddy Locsin, talagang hindi na maganda yung pinagtitweet sa init ng ulo. And I understand their frustration because they're doing their level best to get us these vaccines, which are in short supply worldwide, taken. But they're getting allocations for the Philippines. Bakit hindi natin mabili-bili? Hindi ko maintindihan. May pera naman. Hindi naman pwedeng sabihin na walang pera.
Okay, let's clarify that point, Senator Marcos, okay? Because the president himself seemed to make an effort during his last telecast na parang it seems that he wanted to clarify where the money is. Was this question or issue raised by the Senate in reference to the possibility that the money is has been stolen or may corruption, or is it pertaining specifically to where's the vaccine? Kasi parang yun yung tanong eh. Hinahanap ba ninyo yung pera dahil nagdududa kayo na nawala yung pera, or dahil hinahanap nyo yung bakuna?
Well, predictably, sa Senado, si Senator Ping Lacson, whose advocacy is really going after the budget and making sure that every peso is spent wisely. Predictably, si Senator Ping talagang tinututukan asan yung pera. At ganun din naman si Senator Risa Ontiveros. Ako, mababaw lang kaligayahan ko. Alam ko na hindi sabihin na natin na nandyan yung pera buong-buo. At sinabi nga ni Secretary Dominguez that in fact, not the entire amount is dedicated to vaccines. Okay. But at the end of the day, asan ba yung bakuna? Yun ang tinatanong ko. Because these amounts have been allocated very early on. As a matter of fact, it's not just a question of the sums, right? Una, may pera pa pambili. Ikalawa, bakit ang tagal-tagal? Kasi nga, even the ambassador from China is really mystified. They were offering the Chinese vaccines in June, since June of last year. Why weren't they allowed to come in? And this is also what our Chinese chambers have been complaining about. Is it the FDA? Is it the DOH? And then the alcohol and tobacco companies, they won't even be given a copy. A copy of the famous tripartite agreement. Payag naman sila eh, dun sa tripartite na idadaan sa FDA, inspectionin yung DOH, 50% idodonate. Payag sila sa lahat na yon. Pero they're not being allowed to import. So there's a whole issue of red tape, policy, where's the money? Ang daming tanong eh.
Yeah, someone raised that issue to me just the other day. Sito, why is your government or the Food and Drug Administration in the Philippines acting like they're so much better than the health something in UK and in FDA in America? Parang yung ibang bansa nagbigay na nitong mga permiso na ito, dito hinaharang pa rin. And then yung iba sasabihin, hindi kasi Big Pharma, hindi kasi yung Bloomberg. So,
yeah.
Is this power tripping or are people just scared? Because, I mean, I can understand the FDA officials, so to be fair with them, they're probably scared like hell na baka mamaya may mangyari, sila naman ang makulong. And it all boils down to laws that the Senate and Congress may have to craft, yung indemnification law, revising the vaccination law, or itong cover insurance for the FDA. Kasi wala tayong choice, we're pressed against the wall, we need any kind of medicine available, pati nga yung ivermectin, pinag-aawayan, pinag-aawayan na ngayon. And most people I speak with said, Sito, siguro kailangan talaga yung Senado umupo na, pag-usapan na talaga at himayin na lahat itong mga tanong na ito and address it with laws because the bureaucracy is fueled and operates on laws.
Yes, that's correct. Actually, we've been sitting as a committee of the whole for a long time. Nakailang buwan rin kami na committee of the whole. And then yung budget. Like I said, wala nang tigil to. At saka nag-hearing kami. Palibasa nga hindi pumapasok sa Senate. There's no excuse. We just have virtual sessions all the time. And it goes on and on, like you said, for hours on end. And as a matter of fact, the Philippines is one of the first to pass a vaccination law. And we passed it in February 26. And as mentioned by the president, there's no blanket immunity, but there's a very clear indemnification clause for all side effects and other ill effects that derive from the administration and usage of the vaccine, provided it's not because of willful misconduct or gross neglect. So, andun. Pero yung blanket immunity, tama naman si presidente, talaga may hindi pwede yun. Nobody can be deprived of the right to sue. Pero naka-limit. And then we allocated a hefty sum, 500 million pesos at this time of COVID is a heck of a lot of money. So we did that and we will continue to do that. The problem really is that in the end, the enforcement or the implementation of all these laws is in the hands of the executive. So it's our hope that we can make certain that these policies are really implemented properly kasi nagiging dead letter law kung wala rin nangyayari, hindi ginagastos yung pera or nauubos sa red tape or else binabago outright ng mga IRR and administrative orders that are in complete opposition to the law that was passed in the first place.
Okay, last question, quick question, Senator Imee.
Sobrang frustrated ba ang dating ko? Sobrang frustrated.
Welcome to the club.
Alam niyo, ang problema, galing kasi ako sa pagiging governor. Local government official ka, kahit big fish ka in a little bowl, kung anong sabihin mo, kaya mong panindigan, kaya mong i-implement at sundin. Diyan pala sa Senado, daldal ka ng daldal, pasa ka ng pasa, you keep studying, keep debating, you keep doing. But in the end, in the implementation, taas kamay ka, no? You just watch and, pray.
Okay, well, as a former local government official, what do you have to say about the hot bath that your cousin Alfred Romualdez just took this week? Kasi kaibigan ko naman si Alfred, pero sabi ko nga, pare, mukhang nabanlian ka. What do you have to say?
Alam mo, si Alfred, parating biroan namin sa mga magkakamag-anak, kaya alam ninyo si Alfred, napi-PTSD na yun eh. Kasi pagkatapos ng Yolanda, hilong-hilo na talaga siya na binibiro nga namin and kailangan i-debriefing na yung batang yan. So, you know, like many of us, nakaka-mental health issue na itong COVID. Kapag nakapreso ka ng isang taon na wala kang kinikita at puro emergency, you know, all the local government officials, sagad na yung mga yan. Wala nang resources. Mabuti pa yung mga NCR, maraming ang COVID, pero at least maraming resources. But what about 4th, 5th, 6th class municipalities? And then hindi naman biro yung ginagawa natin dahil yung hesitation, yung vaccination rejection. Ayaw talaga ng tao, di ba? Nasa 50%. We haven't done a good enough job of convincing people to get vaccinated. So dapat yung dating rule ng mass vaccination vaccination, yung quick substitution, eh yung policy na yan, pag may ayaw, eh di dapat yung next nakapalit, para hindi nasasayang yung bakuna. So this is what we're praying for. And we hope that instead of lambasting the local government officials, ang national government, ibabagsak rin ninyo yung responsibilidad sa mga LGU. Tulungan na natin yung LGU. Let's give them part of the money. Let's give them buddies of old officials. Let's recruit the medics from the military and the police. Let's help the LGUs. Ngayon, we have a new bogeyman. Yung mga mayor naman ang upakan natin. Ayoko talaga na singit-singit yung VIP at wala akong balak magsingit. Pero maintindihan mo rin ang sitwasyon ng LGU. Mga hino na yan.
Okay, now, would you recommend or would you call on the President, Mr. President, Tay Digong, para ngawa mo na magpabakuna ka na in public para hindi nababanatan yung mga mayor na napipilitang magbabakuna?
I know. I think the president himself has come forward and he said something about the LGUs getting vaccinated ahead of the others was a gray area. Hindi ko sure kung ano yung pagkarinig ko. But the president, having been a local government executive, knows full well the power of example in the LGU. Particularly, sabihin na natin may pagka-racist yung Filipino. Yung unang dumating kasi yung mga China vaccines, takot na takot yung mismo yung mga doktor at health worker. Umaayaw, sir, mauna ka. Narinig ko yung taga Bohol eh, na mayor. Kawawa naman si Mayor Mendez. Sabi niya, ayaw eh. Masasayang, itatapon yung bayal. Eh, bukas na. So I don't know if these are excuses, but certainly there is something to be said. We saw, after all, a lot of world leaders like President Widodo of Indonesia. We saw Lee Hsien Loong in Singapore. Lahat sila with the entire cabinet, diba? It was a whole ritual with the pre-testing and then the vaccination and then the wait for side effects. It was all on television. So that's another style.
Okay, well, I have to end it here, Senator Imee Marcos. But thank you very much for accepting our invitation and for sharing our grief and our displeasure. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
I'm so sorry that I couldn't provide more solutions and more answers, but certainly I need solution. sabi ko nga, dito hindi na solution, nahihirapan na rin tayo. So let's pray and hope fighting ang Filipino, and let's pray for better management of this COVID response. Thank you so much for the opportunity, Chito.